Your institution may be well-intentioned, but oftentimes deep-seated policies and social norms communicate negative messages and create unintended bias toward minority groups. One way to combat this is with a specially designed anti-bias advocacy plan for your campus. Dr. Laura Narend has outlined three main areas that such a plan should address. The first area is policy, deconstructing and rebuilding procedures that are unintentionally discriminatory. For example, Dr. Narend's campus was recently criticized because unintentionally, the vast majority of recipients of their Martin Luther King scholarship were white.
Well, some of the criteria that we use to judge who gets that scholarship are things like professionalism and poise, things that we might think are neutral and fairly applied to everyone. But if I'm a student calling from a Burger King because that's the only access I have to a telephone, my ability to be professional, right, is going to look a little bit different than if I'm calling from the comfort of my parents' home, they're sitting there with notes, grooming me. So there's a lot of these embedded privileges in our policies that are something that we need to look at.
The second area to address is shared dialogue. Build capacity on your college campus to hold important conversations.
So there's examples on some college campuses of hosting what are called taboo dialogues, and it's sort of an open acknowledgement that we're going to come together and talk about things that we don't always talk about, and or courageous conversations is another kind of buzzword that's used. But hosting those in a variety of different settings. So maybe Greek Life hosts a couple, maybe you know the Black Student Union hosts a couple. Depending on the organization, maybe you have one for people who work at admissions, right, to look at how they talk about students, potential students.
Microaggression is an emerging current term that refers to small day-to-day aggressions experienced by minorities that the perpetrator might not even recognize as bias or prejudice. The last area to examine is how to eliminate these instances of personal bias.
And there's strategies associated with that you should always interrupt a bias remark or comment every time. You should question people to understand where did that come from. Oftentimes, just in the questioning, the speaker can't really locate where that comes from because it's something that's just been internalized. And so creating a culture on our college campuses where it's expected that bias incidents will be immediately acknowledged and that we will support others who do that.
Make sure your anti-bias advocacy plan examines policy, creates opportunities for dialogue, and addresses personal bias, and you'll be well-equipped to create a campus that's welcoming to all groups. For more videos on diversity and inclusion, click subscribe and never miss an episode.